working-class suburb of Jordan's capital, there's an ordinary family with an extraordinary tale. These children look happy enough, but their mother is dead, killed by their father. Now they're cared for by his sister Etidal while he's overseas on business. The family accused their mother, Hanan, of having an affair. So to preserve the family honour, her husband Anwar murdered her. Their 12-year-old son Senad, who was 6 then, witnessed the whole thing. Senad's auntie Etidal agrees.
عشان كويس ما عنا لحالنا عند كل الناس اللي بس عندهم قضية شرف إنه إيش عظيم إنه الواحد يقتل اللي بتعمل الغلط. عند كل الناس إنه إيش عظيم إنه يقتل هاي. كنت أقول الناس يعني بيحكوا في العادات يعني اللي إصبعه بعمل بيقطعه.
Officially, 13% of Jordanian murders are honour killings, violence against women in the name of family honour. But official statistics grossly underestimate the problem.
In recent months, Jordan's constitutional monarch, King Abdullah II, has called for radical changes to turn this country into a modern democracy, a civilized model for tolerance and freedom of thought. Despite this, every year, women are killed by their cousins, brothers, uncles, and even fathers to keep the family's honor intact.
Jordan is one of the most liberal countries in the Arab world. Here, women are better educated than many of their Middle Eastern counterparts, and they can vote. Officially, there's equality between the sexes. A glaring weakness, it's in the punishment for those who kill in the name of honor. Using honor as a defense, a man can serve just 6 months in jail instead of a 15-year term for murder. Journalist Lima Nabil began investigating the plight of Arab women 17 years ago. To her amazement, she found teenage girls held in prison simply for their protection.
So I started talking with them. I still remember the first one, she was 13 years old, raped by her father. She's in prison, he's outside. When it comes to the honor crimes, a woman is always, always, always a victim, and a woman is always the one who's to blame, even if she's not, innocent.
Lima makes regular visits to Jordan's first women's shelter, one of just a handful. It's a short-term solution for someone at risk of domestic abuse.
مرحبا. كيفك؟ لوزين؟ أخبارك؟
لوزين is a 23-year-old runaway. She's one of 12 children in a religious family. Since she left school 5 years ago, her father has forced her to stay at home until he finds her a suitable husband. It's not the first time she's run away.
هو أبوي قاسي طبعا هيك
أبوك هيك دايما قاسي
وبعدين يعني بس رجعت يعني حتى هي كل خواتي مش طايقين حتى حد يشوفني ولا يحكي معي يعني مثل الغريبة بين أهلي تخيل الواحد يعني غربة وهذا
In search of comfort and affection, Lujain became romantically involved with a man. Her father was furious.
تخيلي شو يعني نفسيتي حتى امبارح تعبت فجأة وهيك يعني كثير سهر علي.
يلا شو بدك تسوي؟ إن شاء الله تكون هاي بداية لحياة منيحة. نيجي نزورك وننبسط إحنا وياكي. انبسطي انبسطي انبسطي. ضحكي وإن شاء الله. إن شاء الله تكون إشي منيح نضل نيجي نزورك
إن شاء الله
Lujain has no choice now but to return home She has nowhere else to go Lima Nabil has dealt with dozens of cases like Lujain's domineering fathers treating powerless daughters like prisoners Many of these cases end in the tragedy of an honor killing, or at the very least, broken lives. In this neighborhood, everyone knows why Shahrukh and her family moved here. Each afternoon, she fetches five-year-old son Ahmed from the school bus. Shahrukh isn't her real name. It means sunrise. She chose it to signify a new beginning. This is her second marriage. She and her new husband have three children. But she was forced to leave six behind with her first husband. They struggle to make ends meet, but she's glad just to be alive. Shahrukh had a miserable upbringing with a father who mentally and physically abused her.
ضحكني في المطبخ طال البابور على المساحة على بعرفش إيش بطلع بدريتش عن حالي إلا أنا مجروحة هنا ثلاث غرز
أحملك
She thought life would get better after she left home but it didn't it only got worse
Shahrukh's ordeal began more than 25 years ago when at the age of 17 she was forced to marry a man she didn't like. She had six children with him and he divorced her three times, on the third time returning her to her parents. But living with an abusive father was more than she could bear and she ran away several times. At one stage, she was locked inside a bathroom for 5 years.
How did you manage to survive for all that time, living in something as small and awful as a bathroom?
تعرف حتى وأنا في الحمام يعني واحد ينحط في غرفة خمس سنين لازم ينجم. بس أنا ربنا كان مسلط علي أشياء رهيبة يعني مثلا أحفظ قرآن أصلي أكون في الليل أصلي أصوم يعني هيك أقرأ كتب دينية أقرأ يعني ما كنتش حاسس كثير بالإشي بس كان كل هدفي إني أخرج
The police were eventually summoned and for her own safety they said she was put in prison After being released her father and brothers finally decided she had brought the family enough embarrassment
سكر عليهم الباب واجى اخوي حسين ما شاء الله عنه محترم تخدير وجامعي وهيئه بعلم ابوي شو يعمل بحكي له يلا اقضى عليها تخه سكروا ما خلوش الشرطه تيجي اجى ابوي اول مسدس وتج على جسمي طخ 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 انا طبعا لا خفت ولا قادر اتحرك ولا شيء بس بقول اشهد ان لا اله الا الله واشهد محمد رسول الله خلص المسدس الاولاني على جسمي اجى اخوي ممرض ما شاء الله بده يشوفني اكتشف اني لساتني ما متت بيحكي له يا بابا المسدس الثاني على راسها سنتر على راسها خليها تموت
Sharuk was rushed to hospital with 6 gunshot wounds. Incredibly though, she lived. Her father was arrested, but relatives convinced her to drop the charges against him, which she did.
نزلت عن حقي أصلاً لمصلحته ولمصلحته. تعرفي لو أنا ما تنزلت كان أنا في السجن معه.
She thought it would buy her freedom. Now she wants revenge.
تعرفي أنا نفسي الناس يساعدوني عشان أعاقبه. أرفع قضية عليه. على عشان أعاقبه على طفولتي اللي ما عشتهاش وعلى المراهقة اللي تهمني فيها وعلى التهم الشنيعة اللي عايشني فيها 43 سنة وأنا عايش لحد الآن عايش زي المنبوذة في الشيء لأهلي ولا إلي حدا ولا وأي حدا بعمل إخواني بكرهوني إخواني بكرهوني بدون سبب.
Has anyone from your family ever been punished for what they've done to you?
فش حدا بعاقبهم. فش حدا. ما فش حدا بقدر يعاقبهم.
It's a lesson young boys like Senad learn early.
Do you miss your mother? Why?
عشان هي بقت تحب واحد غيره. بتحبش بابا.
Do you think she deserved to die?
Yes.
Is that what your father and your auntie says?
لأني حالي. أني حالي.
Etidal Shalami clearly remembers the day 6 years ago when her brother Anwar killed his wife Hanan. They were first cousins. But the only regret she has is that her brother served almost 7 years in prison. More than 14 times the usual punishment for an honor killing.
لا مش عادلة عقوبته لازم قانون الحكومة 6 شهور فكون أمها اشتكت عليه أخذ 7.5 هو لازم ينحكم 6 شهور ويطلع قضايا الشرف معروف في أردن في أي دولة إسلامية 6 شهور
What if a woman isn't guilty but dies anyway? As a woman yourself, doesn't this make you angry?
لا أكيد إذا ظلم بدي أحزن عليها إذا ظلم بدي أحزن عليها وتعاطف معها كونها مرأة ومظلومة بنفس الوقت لأنه حرام تنكتل مظلومة بس فيش واحد من قضايا الشرف انكتلت وهي مظلومة أبدا مستحيل يعني
In the process of Jordan's modernization, there's an inevitable clash between new and old. Islamic conservatives believe imitating Western culture can corrupt society. While many young, wealthy Jordanians cast off traditional values which oblige a woman to control her public behavior. But virtually without exception, society regards misbehavior by a woman as more damaging to a family's honor than misbehavior by a man. To a private university to hear what the younger generation thinks. They're all aged between 21 and 23 from wealthier families. I asked the men how they would react if they discovered their wife had cheated on them.
If I knew that my wife has cheated me, I'll kill her, simply. Yes.
So is that the view that most people would have in Jordan?
99% in Jordan is like this.
I disapprove, no. Okay. No, if any territory happened, okay, there is a law, okay, people go to the to law. Yani we're not barbarians, okay?
In Islam, if some girl not married and she had some sexual relationship, she can be punished, okay? But if she's married, Islam said that she had to be killed.
Usually men in our society, they choose from religion what they want. Okay, like marrying four women, you know, about killing their women. But they don't, I mean, look at them, they don't do anything that religion says. So they choose what they want.
What if someone accused you of doing something wrong? Do you think you could defend yourself if you were accused of some kind of wrongdoing?
I guess not. It's hard to defend yourself in this society.
In Sharuk's home, her husband Khaled treats her well, and her new life is a success. But nothing can bring back her wasted youth or heal the scars from an abusive upbringing.
حطم طفولتي الله لا يسامحه لا عندي طفولة ولا عندي مراهقة ولا عندي أي شيء في الدنيا ما عشت أي شيء هي أصلا بنت لما تتربى كويس وتلاقي أبو حكيم ما في بصير شغلات زي هيك أما تحكي إنه جرائم الشرف يعني ده تنتهي على مدى أجيال لا ما أعتقدش في أطفال بنشأوا يعني ممكن الأب ينشئ ابنه أنا هلا إخواني ممكن ينشئ أولادهم وأولاد أولادهم على نفس المبدأ مستحيل يتغير مثلا زي إخواني يعني.
Jane is preparing to leave the women's shelter to return to her family. Her only hope is to marry a husband, kind, gentle, and open-minded enough to treat her as an equal. But in a society where men regard family honor as literally a matter of life and death, there are no guarantees.